Hello, it's Kevin Bacon again, and it's always nice to start a video out with some kitties, but this video's not about kitties. And even though you can see the rabbits in here, these are my most recent babies. They're getting pretty big. Of course, their mommy, this is not their mommy, their mommy's gone. And then that, of course, over there, daddy. This is about these feeders. You see, it's almost empty. This one's only half full. That one is way down there, maybe a third. But these rabbits haven't increased their feed consumption. And certainly the pellet production underneath them hasn't increased. So, where's all my feed going? Well, I just realized you were probably just looking down at the bottom. It's gone to opossums. And I know nobody ever calls them opossums around here, around where I grew up. They're just possums. But what happens is these possums come in here. They climb up on here. They lift the lid. They reach down in there. They eat all the food. Sometimes the lid gets closed. Sometimes the lid is left open. Then they go on to the next one over here that doesn't have a lid on it. They eat the food, and they go over here to the buck's cage, and they eat the food. Now, these aren't very big possums. They're leaving their leavings up on top of my cage. I mean, I'm sure that wasn't something you necessarily wanted to see, but there's a problem with possums. Not are they only stealing my food, but they also carry a couple of really nasty buggers. One of them is called EPM, and EPM is a problem that gives horses a lot of trouble and some other animals a lot of trouble with their nervous systems. Back to our toxoplasmosis. Okay, toxoplasmosis, most people have it. It's not a big deal. It's a little parasite that just runs around and probably doesn't cause you any trouble at all unless your immune system gets severely compromised, and then it can do some nervous damage. But there are some animals that it really, really wreaks havoc with, and that's my little kittens. It causes them to have severe deformations of their eyeballs and blindness, and it causes them to have pneumonia, lung diseases, and then it attacks their nervous system until their digestive system doesn't work anymore. And then it attacks their nervous system until their muscles all just tighten up and they just die. And it's really a pretty horrible thing to watch, but it's taken me a long time to figure out exactly what it was. And now I figured it out. So it's coming from these possums. Well, we got to stop them. So I can't be out here to guard these rabbits all the time. And if this is where they're getting part of their food, the other part of their food is coming from the porch where the cats get fed. I am installing an electric fence. Now, this is a dog fence. It's not quite as powerful as you might have for horses and other stuff. But it is amazingly effective. And did a marvelous job keeping a Great Dane in the dog fence earlier this year. She could walk right over the fence, but once I put the electric fence up, that was the end of that. So I'll hang it up here. I'm going to take it from there. I'm going to take it through that piece of wood there, and then around the top here, and over here, a couple inches out from the wall here, and then across to the corner over here till we get above this feeder, and then across and over the top of this feeder. And tie it off somewhere over here on the end of this thing. So hopefully that's the end of it. My tarps from last year to keep my rabbits warm in the wintertime, some of them are getting a little bit shabby, but I have another one over here. It's just painter cloth. These cages over here are empty, so I don't have to do anything with them this winter. I'm not likely to breed anymore. All right, but without further, we'll get a picture of these the fence after I hook it up. Well, I had remembered this as a dog fencer, but now I realize it's a 2 mile range regular fencer. So considering it's only going about 12 feet, we should have plenty of get up and go to do this job. We're on a insulated wire, not horribly insulated wire. It's just a, I don't know, 14 gauge automotive wire around and down to the hot wire. Hot wire runs, we'll back up a little bit here, runs across that feeder and over and across that feeder and over and across the top of that feeder. Now that takes care of those folks. Now, to turn it on up here, I have a four-way plug, and it's totally sheltered from the weather up here. And it has a switch on it with a light. And I think there's a little green light. So I can tell if it's hot or not. We can watch. And the red light is coming on saying, yep, the fence is okay. All right. I don't have anything up here to test the fence with. I don't think. Otherwise, I would show you how nicely it pops. Maybe we can push it down with a zippy tie here. Hard to see it and to do it at the same time. No, not going to do that. All right. Suffice it to say, I'm sure that the possum won't like it. So, there we go. I'll keep you posted as to how it turns out. And I know that in the past week or so, I've lost a couple of gallons of feed to these critters. And these guys are only eating about half a gallon a day. So that would have been 4 or 5 days worth of rabbit feed. Right this time of year, they're not doing anything. They're just sitting there, and so they don't burn a lot of energy. All right. Enough shaking around here. Hope everybody didn't get too horribly dizzy. Come back and bye for now. There's Francis. I'll tell you the story of the Francises. Look carefully at the color, because that's the whole story.